have the editor of The Scrawl, a new Calgary journalism venture that launched in September, and little known fact, also one of my first interns, which is a very good choice of mine. Please put your hands together for Jeremy Klossus.
I'm happy we're in a church, because it has to do with my talk, but I hope I'm not too far over the line. So there's a bit of a disclaimer there. We'll see how it goes. All right, so this is a talk, a personal story about a series of choices that I regretted for a long time. First, I need to tell you some backstory. So my education, right from grade one, was in conservative evangelical Christian schools. And for the sake of simplicity, let's call it Jesus Land. Think of it as a Jason Kenney utopia, okay? So growing up in Jesus Land, I absorbed a few erroneous ideas, such as, one, I was intrinsically a bad person and Jesus was disappointed in me. And two, to offset this badness, I needed to do something heroic for God. And this hero narrative showed up in some truly weird ways, such as the image you're seeing right now. This is an image of something called the Power Team. I went to see these guys when I was a kid, and they would roll up frying pans with their bare heads, these beefy Christian men. And other guys on the stage would be yelling, "Do it for Jesus, man! Do it for Jesus!" And so, there's a lot to unpack here, but suffice it to say, in Jesus Land, it was not enough to be ordinary. So after high school in Jesus Land, I signed up for a missionary school in Victoria, except it's not an ordinary missionary school. It's a snowboarding missionary school. And this makes it different. We are going to go to the slopes and reach people for Jesus. And I just got to say as an aside, it's amazing what Google Images will cough up when you put it in search. This, I take, is a gift from above. And so I go to this mission school, and it seems good on paper. We're going to talk to people about Jesus and whatnot on the slopes. But it's a disaster. I'm like the world's worst missionary. The big problem with me as a missionary is I don't like talking to people about Jesus. And you need to be able to do that if you're a missionary. And it gets worse, because for our mission, we go to the Olympics in Salt Lake City, which is awesome, and it's a blast. But it's not exactly a punishing mission thing. We go to some of the best spots to snowboard in the Pacific Northwest, and it's fun, and I'm loving it, except I kind of had this accumulated guilt, like I've converted nobody. And I've raised money from people in my church. I'm saying, I'm going to the snowboarding thing. I'm gonna convert people, and it's not happening. And so I get to the end of this thing, the end of this mission school, and I see, you know what? There's still a way for me to make a mark for Jesus. And in Victoria, I go to the tattoo shop, and I say, I want a Jesus tattoo. They say, where do you want? I say, I want it right here on my arm, where I can't hide it. Right where everybody can see it. So up there you can see my big ass Jesus tattoo. So I kind of got it done in pieces. It looks terrible. And even as I'm getting this thing, I'm like, this is a terrible decision. Like this, I feel sick as I'm getting this tattoo. I'm 18 years old. And I just feel sick. And it gets worse. Like I moved to Calgary. Strategically, kind of in front of the Jesus lives on my arms. I don't like talking about Jesus. But I work at Subway, and I make a mistake in cheese or the Subway melt, and people are looking through the sneeze guard, and it's right there, Jesus lives. And they're asking me about it. And I don't like talking about him. That's how I got in this whole predicament in the first place, is I don't like talking about Jesus. So this is like, a total gong show. And I'm burning with shame over this decision. Like, what was I thinking? And it seriously gets to the point where I fantasize about losing my arm in some kind of not many opportunities to be dismembered. So I didn't think I could work on a farm or something. But I'm happy to report you don't actually have to go to those extremes. You can actually get tattoos covered with other tattoos. And that was an epiphany for me. So I go back to my dad in Calgary. I say, look, man, I love what you did with Jesus. It's awesome. But I've kind of mellowed on the Jesus thing. So can we do a cover? And he says, yeah. And he was real good about it. You know, he was like, you know, people change over time. You got nothing to be ashamed of. It's okay. So he does a great job, and he covers it with forest flowers. And I'm happy with it, and he's happy with it. But then something kind of weird happens. Where, you know, my plan was to cover up all this religious stuff on my own. But then I'm like, you know what? It started to not bother me as much, strangely. And I found I almost had this weird affection for my obscenely large Jesus. Like, for better or for worse, that's part of my story. And who am I to reject that part of my story? So I decided, you know what? Maybe I have this for a reason. And it occurred to me the reason. Do you guys know who this is? Larry Heather, mayoral candidate. And, it's too much to get into. But anyways, I get a real kick out of the fact that I found Jesus, this guy. This guy tweets about Jesus and all this stuff, and I'm like, dude, you don't even know I've had Jesus to you. This takes real commitment. Anybody can write some tweets. And so, I made peace. I'm here to tell you, in this context of this church, I made peace with Jesus, and I'm serious, I'm not being facetious here. The people sometimes ask, you know, are you going to cover up your Jesus tattoo? And I'm like, no, I don't think I will. I think it would be false somehow. And so what have I learned from this? Moral of the story, if you will. I can just be myself, and who I am isn't bad, contrary to what I learned in Jesus' life. Be authentic, be weird, be who you are without shame. That's good. Jesus said, the kingdom of God is within you. I think maybe I'm finally starting to learn how to understand that. Thank you.